You know what I'm afraid of? I'm afraid I'm going to drop my keys in that sewer grate in the middle of the parking lot. You ever see that sewer? If I see the sewer in the parking lot, I will park two spots away to avoid the sewer. And then I get out, I hold on my... Oh, shit, I got to hold the keys. I'm walking over the sewer. I don't want to drop them. Because I think what would happen if you drop your keys in there? Who do you call? The fire department? What are they going to do? Oh, you dropped your keys in the sewer? Yeah, you should have parked two spots away, asshole. 'Cause for me, because you see, I am, like I said, Greek Italian, and the thing, Greek Italian, Jewish, whatever religion or nationality you are, one thing we all have in common is we're all very, very good at holding grudges, aren't we? We're very good at it. My family was really good at holding grudges, and I even got good at it. I got so good at holding a grudge, I didn't talk to myself for 2 years. That's how good I got and holding a grudge. And you know, I grew up, it was a fun family. I had an Aunt Amelia. I loved my Aunt Amelia, you know, because she would sit me on her knee and she would read me stories and she would bounce me up and down on her knee and she had these big tits that would just hit me right in the face. Awesome. At five-year-old boy, that was like paradise. At 17, it got a little weird, but at five, Aunt Amelia. And then all of a sudden, one day, Aunt Amelia stopped coming over. She just stopped coming over. And a couple of weeks went by, she used to come over all the time. And I said to my mother, what happened to Aunt Amelia? Oh, we don't talk to Aunt Amelia anymore. I'm like, why? What did she do? She knows what she did. Which is Greek for nobody fucking knows what she did. But you know what they don't realize is when there's a grudge, they didn't talk to Aunt Amelia. That means I can't have Aunt Amelia's big tits hitting me in the face anymore. And not only that, all her kids, my cousin Donna and my cousin Nikki, it was like they were just removed from the family tree. We couldn't talk to them anymore. We weren't allowed because there was a grudge. From my aunt, it started from my aunt Sula, which is Greek for asshole, I think. But anyway, she started the grudge, and it was just like, we can't talk to this woman ever again, and nobody else is allowed to talk to this woman. So, you know, it was a big thing, grudges in my family. And it's a midlife crisis. I never understood that, because a midlife crisis is when you get a 21-year-old girlfriend and a Corvette. And why would I ever want a Corvette? But I had the crisis. I had the crisis. Lesbian folk music. So I decided, well, maybe I'll go and talk to somebody. I get a little therapy, you know? First guy I went to, he sat in a room that was really dark. Really, really dark. He had a little chair in the corner, and he sat there like this. He said, tell me what how you feel about coming, and why you feel about it. And, what's going on? I was like, what? What do you say? Why is it so fucking dark in here? What's going on? All right, calm down, calm down. Let's relax a little bit. What I want to ask you is, do you journalize at all? Do you journalize? I'm like, what? Journalize? Journalize. Do you write everything? You should write things down. Write things down? What do you mean? Is this, I want you to buy yourself a book, okay? And every day, write down what you're feeling. And then next Monday, we'll get together again and we'll review what you wrote. I was like, wow, that's a pretty good idea, you know? So the next day I got a book and I started writing shit down. I was like, you fucking Aunt Amelia, son of a bitch. I'm getting a job. I hate these freaking people. Oh, I hate everybody. I got another rape page and another page and another. I went back. I had like 12 pages of shit. I was just like, look at this. Look, look at this. And he went over and he goes, oh, that's very good. That's very good. How does this make you feel? How does it make you feel, all this stuff? It makes me feel like shit. Why do you think I wrote it? No, that's good. That's good. That's good. Okay, here's what I want you to do. do the same thing, you know, and write down everything you feel that happens to you this week, and next week we'll go over it again. I'm like, okay. Next week I'm writing down, instead of 12 pages, I got like 5 pages. But next week I got like 3 pages. And I realized, this son of a bitch is giving me homework. It was like high school all over again. It was Sunday night, my appointment was Monday, I had nothing in the book. I was freaking out. I'm like, will you piss me off? I gotta write something down. I was calling other people. I was calling, yeah, what's going on? I heard you got a divorce. Oh, that's terrible. You're getting a divorce? That's great. Well, how does it make you feel? Let me write that down. Okay. Hey, I heard your grandmother died. That's great. I mean, that's horrible. How does it make you feel? Let me write that down. I was bringing other people told me to this ass. Fuck that guy. Then I went to another guy. True story. The guy fell asleep during our session. He fell asleep. And he thinks I didn't notice. You know, he had the fake eyes. You know, the fake eyeballs. But it was the sleep apnea machine that really gave him away. But I went to another woman who, she kind of helped me. She kind of helped me because you know what she did for me? That nobody else did. She gave me drugs. But then I decided maybe I should read some of these side effects on these drugs because there's some weird shit going on here. I gotta read these side effects for these drugs. Feeling a little weird. I decided I'm gonna read this. Oh my goodness. Nausea. Insomnia. Sleepiness, depression drugs cause depression, death, it's number 4, death. If you experience death, stop taking the drug and call your doctor. Anal leakage, constipation, how do you have anal leakage and constipation? You're just gonna shit all the time, is basically what I'm telling you. Weight gain, no. Tremors, sweating, dry mouth, headaches, depression again. They put depression twice on the list. And it went on and on and on and on and on. And I said, no. I can't do it anymore. I'm not doing the drugs. I'm done. I'm done with the drugs. I'm done with everything. I'm finished. Fuck it. Just gonna grow old and be immature and enjoy my life and enjoy my wife and have a good time. And that's what I did. I said, screw it all. I'm done. I'm done with the drugs. I'm not on the drugs anymore. Have you ever done the drugs? Have you ever done the drug thing? Oh my God, the Prozac. The Prozac and the Paxil. And I did it all. I did it all. So I stopped going to those crazy people. But I did find another lady that actually did help me. She was very nice. She helped me a lot. You know, let me work out things. I got back in touch with my parents. And I remember once I even called my Aunt Amelia. I did. And it went something like this. I said, yeah, hi. This is Steve. Who's this, Donna? Yeah, it's your cousin, Stephen. I know, it's been a long time. Hey, is your mom there, Aunt Amelia? What? Oh, she did. When? Wow, 5 years ago? Shit. Hey, do you know what she did? Yeah, I have no clue either. No freaking clue. Hey, we should get together sometime, you know? Yeah, you're kidding. You live in Ronkonkoma? I live in Holbrook. That's insane. We should definitely get together, yeah. Are you on Facebook? Yeah, I'm on Facebook. All right, yeah. All right, yeah, I'll definitely look you up. I'm going to look you up on Facebook. Yeah, cool. All right, take care, Donna. Look her up. Oh, there she is. She's got big tits. She runs in the family.